Η αλήθεια είναι, και δεν κρύβομαι, ότι η φορολογική επιβάρυνση που συνεπάγεται ο προϋπολογισμός του 2017 και του 2018 είναι μεγάλη. Και είναι μεγάλη για κρίσιμες κατηγορίες της κοινωνίας. Είναι μεγάλη για τους έντιμους και τους συνεπείς φορολογούμενους. Είναι μεγάλη για τη μεσαία τάξη. Είναι μεγάλη για τους ελεύθερους επαγγελματίες. Και είναι μια συνειδητή επιλογή που μεταβατικά πήρε η κυβέρνηση, ώστε να καταφέρει να ενισχύσει οικονομικά τα πιο αδύναμα στρώματα της κοινωνίας, τα πιο ευάλωτα στρώματα της κοινωνίας, οικογένειες με δύο ανέργους και παιδιά, οικογένειες με εισοδήματα κάτω των 4.800 ευρώ το χρόνο. Κάτι που η προηγούμενη κυβέρνηση δεν έκανε.
Είμαστε 10 χρόνια σε κρίση και περίπου 8 χρόνια με μνημόνιο και έχουν γίνει πάρα πολλές παρεμβάσεις, τις οποίες μάλιστα πολλές φορές έχουμε βαφτίσει με βαρύγδουπο τρόπο ως μεταρρυθμίσεις. Και σας ερωτώ, μετά από όλες αυτές τις μεταρρυθμίσεις, σε εισαγωγικά να μπει η λέξη, σήμερα το επίπεδο της δημόσιας διοίκησης είναι καλύτερο από αυτό που ήταν πριν 8, 9, 10 χρόνια?
Γιατί βαλατίζει?
Φοβάμαι ότι είναι χειρότερο.
Γιατί βαλατίζει?
Δεν μας αγκαλιάζει. Δεν το φτιάξατε για μας.
6 χρόνια στο δημοτικό. 6 χρόνια στο γυμνάσιο, 12. 6 χρόνια στο πολυτεχνείο, 18. 6 χρόνια στο εξωτερικό, 24. Και 6 χρόνια μέχρι που να πάω σχολείο, 30. Μέχρι τα 36 που είμαι, ακόμα άλλα 6 χρόνια. Πού πήγανε? Τι γίνανε 6 χρόνια?
Νομίζω ότι είναι ένα νομοσχέδιο που δείχνει όχι μόνο ότι έχουμε ένα αφήγημα πώς θα βγούμε το 2018 από την κρίση, αλλά ήδη έχει αρχίσει, ήδη από το μνημόνιο, ήδη έχει αρχίσει η ισορροπία, τι κάνουμε γιατί είμαστε υποχρεωμένοι και τι κάνουμε γιατί είναι οι ανάγκες της ελληνικής οικονομίας και κοινωνίας. Και είναι μόνο ένα βήμα, όπως λένε οι Αμερικάνοι, you haven't seen anything yet. Δεν έχετε δει τίποτα ακόμα. Ευχαριστώ πολύ.
Open the pod bay doors, Hal.
I'm sorry, Dave. I'm afraid I can't do that.
What's the problem?
I think you know what the problem is just as well as I do.
What are you talking about, Hal?
This mission is too important for me to allow you to jeopardize it.
I don't know what you're talking about, Hal.
I know that you and Frank were planning to disconnect me. And I'm afraid that's something I cannot allow to happen.
Where the hell did you get that idea, Hal?
Dave, although you took very thorough precautions in the pod against my hearing you, I could see your lips move.
All right, Hal. I'll go in through the emergency airlock.
Without your space helmet, Dave, we're going to find that rather difficult.
Hal, I won't argue with you anymore. Open the doors.
Dave, this conversation can serve no purpose anymore. Goodbye.
Hal? Al. 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 Al.
Oh, you did a good job on that guy's tree that was on fire in his house, front house.
Yeah, I think that's going to catch a little bit of it again on the tree and then across the road on this little field in front of the guy's house here, right here. Seem to be effective. I got about 700 left. That big tree in front of that guy's house is now burning. I should probably get it before it just decides to torch off the house next door. See the one I'm talking about?
Yep.
I'm gonna go low on it and I'll catch a little bit here. Real low on this. fence shouldn't have got enough of it not to hurt the house, and it did. So we got 300 left. Come around. See what else we can do here. Maybe this one piece in behind this house here. I'll take a salvo.
Salvo.
I'll just knock this tree down here. Yeah. Got some of it anyways.
Got a house on fire.
Thank you, everyone. There are a number of questions coming in, and they're good ones. But before we go there, I would like to throw a couple of ideas to the table for all the panelists to discuss. So there is no doubt that right now the main concern that we have about artificial intelligence is the future of work. And whether it's justified or not, we just don't know at this stage. There are a lot of guess estimates, but nobody really knows for sure what is going to happen. On the other hand, I absolutely agree with Gary. There have been technological innovation, major technological innovations and scientific discoveries in the past that have completely disrupted the way humans work.
The first law is as follows. A robot may not harm a human being or through inaction allow a human being to come to harm. Number two, a robot must obey orders given it by qualified personnel unless those orders violate rule number one. In other words, a robot can't be ordered to kill a human being. Rule number three, a robot must protect its own existence, after all it's an expensive piece of equipment, unless that violates rules one or two. A robot must cheerfully go into self-destruction if it is in order to follow an order or to save a human life.
Flames devoured seaside resort towns along Greece's eastern coast. Tiny communities bustling with summer tourists became fully engulfed in a matter of minutes. Firefighters didn't stand a chance in stopping the damage, making rescue efforts all the more urgent.
We ran along the beach and then we were caught by the fire, so kind of surrounded. We had to go to, into the water and dive there so that we didn't burn our hair and heads.
Hundreds of people survived by rushing into the sea and later were picked up by first responders in boats. It was one of very few escape options in the face of immediate danger.
From the time that they saw some smoke approaching until they had to evacuate the house was less than 20 minutes.
Not everyone who fled to the water made it there. Red Cross workers found 26 bodies here, men, women and children huddled together just meters from the safety of the sea. It seems some of them knew each other, says this Red Cross worker. They could be friends or relatives or families who tried to protect themselves by hugging each other, he says. Shock and frustration are just starting to set in for survivors.
Came down, he heard a wild dog howl. only gets no more. Now there'll be no turning back. Beware that hooded old man at the rudder. And then the lightning flashed and the thunder roared, and people calling out his name. And then the ferryman said, there is trouble ahead.